Kia ora tātou katoa toa. Welcome back. Well, as we saw earlier, Green MP Teanau Tuiono's private members bill has passed its first reading. Now, this is really significant. The bill seeks to repeal a law that prevented Samoans born between 1924 and 1949 from becoming New Zealand citizens. Here to talk more about the bill is MP Teanau Tuiono. Thank you for joining us on the show. Kia ora.
Kia ora and tolofa, everybody.
First of all, tell me, how surprised were you when it was passed this week in Parliament for New Zealand First and especially ACT to support it?
Pleasantly surprised. I mean, like, politics is, I mean, you can never confirm anything. You never know what's going to happen on the day. It can be, you know, you got to be prepare yourself to be ready for the unexpected, to expect the unexpected. So it was good to see it's good to see that all those parties supporting the bill, except for National, of course.
Of course, and it's the first time they've been outvoted since they've come into power. But, you know, there's quite a lot of skepticism that they're putting out there. Cameron Brewer was saying that it will set a legal precedent. They're a bit concerned about it. But what do you have to say to what some of the things they've been putting out there about fears of mass migration?
I think it's really important not to conflate citizenship with immigration. You know, they're actually administered by two different government departments. Citizenship, passports, all that kind of thing is a Department of Internal Affairs. Immigration is a Department of Immigration. And we, as you know, the Greens have got lots of opinions about immigration. And though those things are related, they are also can be dealt with in separate ways. So I think that was not very well understood by the National Party. What resonated with me from members right across the House was two things. The first one was fairness. Everybody, I think, got that. You look at this, you have a group of New Zealand citizens who had their citizenship recognised by the Privy Council and then had that taken away from them, so that was one thing. And then the second thing was that commitment to community and commitment to the Samoan community, the role and the contribution that the Samoan community makes here to Aotearoa New Zealand, also respect for elders. So that came out from everybody else, I felt.
And you had a very big delegation of Samoans who came in the House and they were listening, and even particularly some very important people had come from Samoa as well for it. What was their reaction with the first reading being passed this week?
There was a lot of cheering in the public gallery. That was awesome to hear, to sort of feel the passion and the energy from the community. We had the Speaker of the House from Samoa, of the Samoan Parliament, in the public gallery. I had members of Parliament from both political parties in the gallery with them. They were over here on a delegation, so it was awesome to have them there as well. We had Anaiatha and I in the gallery as well, so having a former MP from the National Party was also like significant. And also Opito came into the chamber and he was sitting up the front there as well. So having Opito in the chamber with us as well was special.
And you talk about that fairness that needs to be restored there, that justice. Tell me, how many Samoans specifically will this bill impact?
When we think about the number of elders that are still with us, we estimate there's less than 5,000, maybe around 3,500 as well. And so I see the intention of the bill as it's a part of that journey, right? So for those of us who were in Parliament during the Dawn Raids apology, that was the start of a really important journey, and it was a very, very tough conversation. You know, we were all at the town hall when the apology was happening, and it was very emotional for us. This is just another step in that journey. That's what I see it as. But I think a necessary step as well, because when you look at the injustice that came with this bill, and I was being contacted by, you know, Samoans the same age as me, people that I've known for a while, like a professor and some others who said, you know what, while we're doing this, there's other things that needs to be done, and this was one of them.
And you reference also the late Whanana Efesa Collins in your speech being instrumental in helping, you know, push this across. Would have been a bittersweet moment as well, having that first reading pass this week without him by your side.
Yeah, it was very bittersweet for all of us in the caucus. We still miss him a lot. We have his picture in the caucus room, and he has been on my mind a lot this week. Yeah.
Well, what happens next? And we talked about the community and obviously that show of force that was there this week. I'm thinking about the beautiful besse that resounded out throughout the House. How important will the community be in seeing this bill progress?
Because we've gotten through the first reading, we've got the select committee process. So that's the opportunity for the community to come to the select committee and have their stories heard. There'll be, I expect, a range of experiences and a range of important stories, and those need to be shared, but also different perspectives as well. So I would invite the community to come and have your say. You know, submit to the select committee, say you want to make an oral submission so that the MPs, the members of parliament, can hear your voices. And then from there, we can sort of shape the legislation that actually makes sense for everybody. Mm. It has to be practical and workable as well, because it is a members bill, but also it needs to be able to address the issues.
And restore that that right back to those Samoans. But we're almost wrapped up for time. I just want to touch on one more aspect as well that's been happening across the country. A lot of jobs being cut, a lot of government cost cutting. Can we just move on to that quickly?
Yeah, sure.
How do you think that's impacting our community?
I think it will have a massive impact on our community. Every day there's another announcement where public sector cuts, job cuts are happening as well. And here's the thing, right? If you start to get rid of everybody from the public sector, that, you know, the building's going to start to fall over, right? I mean, we know as Pasifika peoples that the people that are in the back room, that do all the work, keep the kitchen humming and all that kind of stuff, that's important. That's so important. Well, all those people are losing their jobs, even, you know, in this place with TV New Zealand and
MPP, happening. Of course.
Yeah,
MPP
as well. So it's going to have a massive impact. And on the subject with the Ministry for Pacific Peoples as well, what I don't think people realise is how important those sorts of jobs are, because there is this. We have this relationship right across the Pacific. You know, we have a treaty of friendship with Samoa, long-standing commitments right across the Pacific, and also we have Pacific Islanders here as well. That helps to shape a regional perspective, and that is being lost in what the national lead government is doing in terms of the public sector job cuts.
Tuiono, thank you very much for coming on the show. Particularly appreciate you coming in and explaining as well about the first reading of your members' bill too. Whaftsai lava.
Me take it on, Nui. Great to be here.